Daisy, what old chaps and chabbits, scone chap and birdie here.
Yes.
Yes, fellows, and I dare say we are now discussing here a rather hotly anticipated title from EA being, of course, The Sims 4, aren't we, old chap?
Well, oh, certainly, old chap, yes indeed. Anticipated by some, but being hotly criticised by others, it would seem.
Really, old boy?
Most certainly, because of various things they've taken away and not added.
Well, indeed. You see, it seems fans of the previous very popular The Sims 3 game are bemoaning and bewailing the absence of a lot of features from the game, as well as some areas where apparently it's been, shall we say, crippled a little bit, you know.
Most certainly. Now, we don't know why at the moment, or perhaps there may be more to come. We don't know. But these people have made some points.
They have, old boy, and apparently all of the things we're going to share here have been confirmed for The Sims 4, so make of this what you will. Now, Bertie, apparently, firstly, I'm told the creator's style feature is gone.
Yes, that's what they say. So there'll be no more customising of colours inside houses, etc.
I see, old boy, indeed. So quite a critical feature for some there, the ability to personalise and customise your Sims worlds, as it were, with the various colour options available. Apparently, that's been taken away. I also, you can no longer create new lots. Lots, of course, are like housing areas for your Sim characters.
Right, so that means you can have... You start off with one, do you? And then you can't create any more? How does it work?
I think you'll start with two and perhaps unlock more, but apparently you can't actually create more lots. Now, also, the ability to terraform or change the makeup and formation of the ground, etc., is gone, and the land is going to be completely flat throughout the entire world.
Ah, so before you could sort of pull the ground up, couldn't you?
That's right.
Like that. But you can't do that in this one.
No, apparently not. So, of course, you could customise and sculpt a landscape before, whereas apparently you're not going to be able to do that in the latest outing. Now, also, no more swimming pools, old chap.
No more swimming pools? Oh, well, never mind. That's out of the window, then.
How are we going to have a dip, I say?
Well, there we are. And also they say that you can't have police, businessmen, or doctors, etc. anymore.
Really? So certain career paths have also apparently been cut from the game, such as medical, business, police and law enforcement, etc. and so forth. And on that note, apparently, the story progression is also gone. That means Sims won't marry, have children, or move, etc., unless you say so. It's not automated.
Aha! So, you can force it, as it were. You can tell them to do so.
Yes.
But they're not just going to progress on their own any longer.
No, that's right. Sort of, they're not going to actually actively take a part in progressing the story by themselves.
Aha! Now, apparently, also, there's no toddlers in this one.
Ah.
And all adults, from teen to senior, are apparently the same height, looking rather similar.
Really, old boy? So not much distinguishing there between adults of ages from teen to senior, and if you don't look closely and zoom in, you might confuse an old person with a young one.
Oh, well, is it possible? Now they say the worlds are about one-fifth the size of those in the previous games.
Really?
Don't know why, well, that's what they say. I don't know why they've done that, but
well,
apparently it's the case.
Indeed seems so. Apparently you're going to be able to have about 25 lots in this one, whereas in The Sims 3 you could have 125 lots, which of course is roughly one-fifth the size. And to be honest, I'm not quite sure why they do such a thing. It doesn't seem to make much sense, but they'll go, that's what they've done, I say.
Well, perhaps there's an option to level up as you go through the game, perhaps. Who knows?
We don't know. Maybe they have plans for the future to change these things with a patch, etc. or so forth, but as it stands, apparently that's been confirmed to be the case.
Now, each lot has an individual loading screen, apparently, which is a bit, well, preposterous, I suppose.
Well indeed. Apparently, Fennels, you're going to have to wait for a loading screen, although we don't exactly know how long, but a loading screen nonetheless each time you want to enter an individual lot, which of course might add a bit of time to the game, I suppose.
What it could do. Now, apparently there's some other missing features also. For example, no acne. Well, that's a good thing, isn't it?
Oh, they've got rid of the acne, old chap. Lovely.
They have.
Well.
And also, there's aliens. Dastardly aliens have gone.
They've got no more aliens.
No aliens at all this one.
Oh, yes. I say, well.
Apparently. Now, no basements, they say. No burglars. Well, that's a good thing as well, I suppose. No cars. No cutscenes. No clothes shopping, no dinner proposals, no dreams, no favourites, no fears, no ghosts, no rabbit holes, no repairmen, no restaurants, no skin sliders, no swimwear, or in-game websites or gerbils.
Not gerbils,
yeah. Oh, sorry, no.
I must say, the one that list that concerns me the most is the absence of swimwear, because swimwear is very important, old chap.
Well, yeah, rabbit holes is quite a good thing not to have, actually.
Well, yes,
they're terrible, because you keep going in the garden, you see, you step down in the holes and it hurts your foot.
It hurts, I've had it before, it hurts awful, you know.
Yes,
sprained
awful,
ankle,
yes.
Good as bad. Now, really? Finally, apparently, Fennels, the game is 32-bit instead of 64-bit. Now, this is quite a strange decision, because it means it will be limited to only 4 gigabytes of RAM for the game, and also, of course, it's not ideally suited to modern 64-bit operating systems.
That's an interesting point. Well, perhaps they're going for a retro type of style.
Well, I don't know, old boy. Certainly it seems indeed the focus this time has been very much slimming down on a lot of the game's features, perhaps cutting out what they thought was some excess fat, as it were, and, of course, we are left with a game here which seems, if you ask me, to be missing quite a few things as compared with The Sims 3, although, of course, I suppose for the final verdict we'll have to wait until the game's actually out.
We certainly will. Of course, the new SimCity was reduced in size compared to previous ones, and it seems The Sims 4 will be downscaled compared to the very popular Sims 3 also.
Well, indeed, old boy. SimCity was, of course, reduced in size, as you say, compared with the previous outings in the series. It seems The Sims 4 is going the same way, and also having a bit of a haircut in terms of features. Now, of course, it remains to be seen how the community is going to receive this, old chap.
Well, so far, they're not very happy with these things, which seem to be the case.
Yes.
But I suppose we'll have to wait till the game actually comes out to verify them for sure.
That's right, but there you are, Fiddles. What do you think? Do you think EA have done a bit of a bad move here, a good move? What do you say, I say?
Well, it's an interesting point, most certainly. Well, I think people are still very excited about the game, but it remains to be seen, as you say, when it actually comes out, whether they're still happy or not.
That's right, old boy. Indeed, it's very much a matter of keeping the buyers happy, just as much as you have to keep the Sims happy, I think.
Most certainly.
Well, there you are, Fiddles. Thank you, guys, for joining us in this game channel, buddy. A news update bulletin of sorts, I say. I'm looking forward to seeing you once more in the next exciting, goodness, man. Until then!